20. On a level horizontal table, a toy race car of mass M moves with constant velocity B around a flat circular racetrack of radius R. Which of the following best represents the minimum coefficient of static friction required for the race car to continue to follow the circular path shown? In a situation like this, a simple graph will tell you that this is not something where you can analyze this with equilibrium equations. There is an acceleration. In this case, that acceleration is pointing towards the center of the circle, like this, while the velocity is pointing forward, like this. And so, the whole idea is that the force that actually keeps the object from getting off the circular path is the friction force. So it is our friction force that acts as the centripetal or net force on this object. Now, if we are talking about the minimum coefficient of static friction, it means that this is the maximum value for the static frictional force, which is equal to the mu s, the coefficient of static friction, times the normal force. On the other hand, the centripetal force is just another name that we assign to the force that is unbalanced, or net force, and therefore from Newton's second law, that's equal to mass times acceleration. Now, in the y direction, we do have equilibrium. So in the y direction, the only two forces that you have on this object are the normal force upward and the gravitational force downward. Therefore, the normal force must be equal to the gravitational force because there is no acceleration in the y direction, which means that you can substitute normal force times the gravitational force, and that is equal to mass times centripetal acceleration. Now you can see then that the mass cancels out, and from algebra you know that your acceleration is equal to the square of the speed divided by the radius. Therefore, the coefficient of static friction as a minimum must be equal to the square of the speed divided by g times the radius, and that is equal to option D.